What is the best platform specifically for language teachers? I'm going to show you one of the tools that I think is the best. I've reviewed many of these tools, but I think Zengengo is exceptional. If you want to set up activities, grammar, listening, speaking activities, etc., get all the students to log on, do the activities, and then to receive those activities in one place where you can give feedback, etc., then this is an ideal tool. It's a technology made by teachers for teachers. I think it's been really well thought through, and I'm going to show you some of my favorite examples of the tools within the platform. There are actually 10 different games and lots of permutations, so loads of activities you can do here. Anyway, hope you like the video. As always, if you do, please like it, please share it with other teachers, please join me on my YouTube channel, and of course I'd love you to comment on which of the activities you like the best. Let's get started. So I'm logged into Zengengo. Remember, you can use Zengengo for free for 1 month, and I'd really advise you to do that. After that, the cost is $10 a month, but you get a lot for your money. And I do have a discount code in this video that I'll share towards the end of the video that will give you a 20% discount. So the first thing we need to do is to create a kind of folder for our class. So I'm going to click here and I'm going to call this new TTV class, teacher training videos class. Click on OK and we're ready to start, and straight away you'll see that there's actually a lot of different activities that we can set up for our students to do. And what I'm going to focus on is some of my favorite ones, and we're going to start with the audio recording. I love getting my students to do speaking activities for homework and then listening and giving them some feedback. So that's where we're going to focus first. What I love about the audio recording is that we can give our students a video to listen to, or some text to read, or some audio, and then they can respond and record a reply or comment on it or answer your question. And that's exactly what I'm going to do. So I'm going to start by giving this audio activity a title, and we're going to call this Presentation from a Bad Speaker. And the first thing I'm going to do is to put some instructions of what I want the students to do. So I've got text media type, and I'm going to just say here, watch the video and comment on 5 mistakes the presenter makes. So I've added my instructions. Now I need to add some more media, so I'm going to add some more media. And the second piece of media that I'm going to add is simply a YouTube video. So click over here on video, click on YouTube, and I've got the video here that I want to work with. So all I need to do from the video is to click on the share button and then copy that link. Really simple. I'm going to jump back to Zengengo. I just paste in the video link, and make sure that you click on this button here, okay? That just updates and embeds the video into the page. So we've got a title, some instructions, and then the video. Now there are a few settings, and really quickly I just want to talk about a few of the settings down here. I've done a lot of work with audio recordings, and you really don't need a lot of time. In fact, at the moment I'm doing some of these activities for myself in Polish, and even 1 or 2 minutes is really challenging for me, and my level is around about kind of 1B. So I would suggest perhaps 2 minutes for this one. Okay, allow students to pause if they need to pause is a good idea. The rest of the settings, leave them exactly as they're set, and click on the save button. We are ready now to share this with activity with our students. So once the game's made, all you need to do really is to click on that button there. Copy link and share that with the students. Now actually we can click here as well, interesting enough, and view as a student and see what it's going to look like. And so if we click here, we can actually see what it's going to look like. And I'm going to write in my name, Tom, and then I'm going to click on next, and what I'm going to see is I've got the title, I've got some instructions, I've got the video to watch, and then I can click on this button here and do my recording. Now I want to show you very quickly what it's like for the student to do the activity and then for the teacher to give feedback. But it's really important that we set the feedback settings. What do we want to do? How do we want to give feedback? My advice is to set it so that you can immediately email the students back their feedback. It's the quickest way of doing it. And I'm just going to show you before we move on to actually do an activity and actually see what it's like for the students and then give them feedback, to show you a really important setting that you do need to make sure you've got set before even really you start creating the activities. So what you need to do is to click on submission settings and make sure that you've got collect students' details on submission and collect student email. And that's going to make it super easy for you to give the feedback. So I'm going to click on save, and now you're going to see what happens when the students do this activity. So all I need to do as the teacher now is to share the link. Remember, here we can quickly view what the activity is going to look like, but here we can actually copy the link and then share that with students. We might be emailing it to them, or perhaps you're going to put it onto a platform. You've also got the link at the top of the screen. So let's log in now as a student on a separate browser so we can actually see what the activity looks like for the student. So I'm going to paste in that link. I click on enter, and you'll notice that the first thing I have to do is to complete my name and my email address. And as soon as I've done that, as a student, I can click on the next button. So you come onto the screen, you've got your instructions, you've got your video to watch, and then you've got your record button here. Sometimes when you click on this record button for the first time, it's going to say, can you connect to your microphone? Of course, say yes. I'm going to click here, and off it goes. I can see it's working. So testing, 1, 2, 3. One of the mistakes he makes is that he arrives late. A second mistake he makes is that he drops his pens on the floor. I can pause if I want to, okay? And then once I've finished, I won't do any more. I just simply click here. Notice I can play the recording back. Yeah, and off it goes. I can see it's working. So testing, 1. Brilliant. And then I can, once I've done that, I can submit it. Now remember, I've given in my email address, just click on OK. The teacher will now get that recording. It does take a few seconds to upload, as you can see at the bottom of the screen. And now we're going to go back and look at what it looks like for the teacher when the teacher wants to give the feedback. So if I refresh this page, hopefully I will be able to see that a student has done this work, and I can see, look, that there has been a submission. And I can therefore click here, so I'm on the, back on the home page here now, and I can view that submission. And what I can do is I can give feedback, the student Tom, so I just click on that here. I can listen to the recording, and then I can write some feedback in here, okay, whatever I want to say to the student. So really easy system to use. I can even give a score, so let's say I'm going to give this student 60%. So simple to do. And then I can send feedback. So what I do is click on send feedback link. Okay, I think I've got everything. Oh, first of all, I've got to save it. I must admit, sorry, I forgot to do that. Got to save the feedback, and then I can send it. Now we've already got the student's email address, so we just click on OK, and immediately that feedback goes to that student. Now if there was any more students, we just click here, move on to the second, and then the third. This controls as you move through. Obviously, we've only got one student. What a brilliant system. What a simple system to use, and how effective that could be. If you want to make use of a code that will give you a 20% discount, you can see the price plans here. This is the one that I would advise you to use, but there is also Teacher Plus, but this will give you plenty of content. Obviously, you will need to sign up, and to sign up, you can click here and just click here, choose a region for storage, whatever's nearest to you, and then choose to sign up with either Google or with Microsoft. Now you can use the free account for 30 days, but you will need eventually to upgrade. If you click on upgrade here, all you need to do is to add in the following coupon, TTV-Russell-2021, and then apply that, and you will notice that the price has been reduced. So you can save yourself quite a lot of money, and then obviously afterwards you can choose whether you want to take, enter your code, press here, and then afterwards choose how you want to pay. And on all these different products, there is a 20% discount. Okay, so we've looked at the speaking activity, and you can do the same with video. So instead of working with audio, if you want to, you could get the students to do a video recording. Obviously, they would use access to a webcam. That would be the easiest way of doing that. So you've got some really good choices there in terms of getting the students to do speaking activities. Of course, you could set it that the students are doing the activity in groups or in pairs. It doesn't have to be individually. Now I'm going to jump over and just show you one more activity type. I really like many of the activity types, but just because I don't want the video to be too long, I'm going to jump over and just show you one more activity type that I really like on Zengengo. So it really is worth looking through all of these activities, but I'm going to just show you this one here, which is the text gap fill, just because it's so easy and really is an activity that obviously when it comes to grammar, etc., we often do with our students. So I'm just going to call this gap fill activity. This is going to be the second activity that we've done. And all I need to do, again, I'm going to input, keep the settings to a minimum. So I'm not going to do any media prompts or anything at all. I just need to paste in some text. So just to save time, I'm going to use some text on my own website. I'm just going to copy that text, come back over to Zengengo, paste that text in. And all I need to do here is to click, first of all, very important, is to click on OK. Okay, and this is where the magic starts. We've literally added in some text, and all I can do now is come down to here and just say, well, which words do I want to remove? So I'm going to call, let's say, founder, and I'll do awards, and I'll do, let's put technology, and I'll do university, and let's see if any more, just a couple more, let's do channel and subscribers. Okay, so simple as that. All I've done is selected the words, and we'll leave those settings. I'm going to click on save. That activity is now immediately ready for my students to do. Again, I would need to share the link, so let's actually share that link and log in now as a student and see what the activity looks like. So I've logged in as a student. Immediately you can see that it's the same as before, because remember, we're asking for the student's email address. And I'm just going to complete this very quickly, and we come through to the next page, and then we just get this opportunity to complete the text. So here I'm just putting the words in. Okay. Really easy. Last one here. So I'm simply gonna, so subscribers, done, and submit. And I'm gonna get immediate feedback actually in this particular activity as well. And of course that will mean that the teacher doesn't really need to give any feedback, but the teacher will know exactly what the score is. What a fantastic, simple, quick, clear system to use. And of course, all that data comes straight back to the student. All the data comes straight back to the teacher as well. Okay, really hope you liked that video. Please come over to teachertrainingvideos.com if you want more free videos. Loads on the opening page. Some of the most popular ones for language teachers. There's also a special section in this area at the top here around languages and lots of other topics. If you want to follow my work, the best thing to do is to sign up to the newsletter. That way you get updated with all the latest videos and the online courses I run and the blog posts. And also at the moment, there's a kind of 12-part video series on using technology in teaching. It's completely free and you will be sent a video every 4 or 5 days. So that's the offer if you sign up to the newsletter. You can also subscribe to my YouTube channel. Don't forget to click on the bell to get up the updates. And finally, if you want to contact me about doing any training with your organization, then you can contact me from the website. And thank you very much. There are some more videos now on the screen of other technologies that you might find interesting.